Some event screen. So I will show you how to show notifications on a screen using a system notifications engine, and how to receive a sign of when user clicked your notification and do something. This example will be more complex because for using notifications you will need to have additional things in your project file. Okay, more easy way to work with notifications is using Emulate 5 library, which is providing access to some legacy stuff coming from Migo to Sailfish and accessing backward compatibility for this stuff. And also to make application to respond on clicking to notifications, need to register the bus service. So we adding the bus functionality to application also. We can not modify this notification, or not modification, not modify this application file, and just we'll create new classes here. First class is will be for showing notifications. Notification helper. And second class will register the bus service. Let's start with the bus. To make it work, to respond our class to notifications, we need to register the bus service for our application, and make it to receive one signal. First thing is adding info for class. We want to make to respond to the bus signals. We'll just order the bus. We need to set an interface name to this class, and in a constructor we will create a simple connection to the service. We need to include some the bus stuff. Need connection. We're creating first device service connection. We need to use a session connection. And session bus, and we registering service. And second thing is registering path. We will need public slot for using notification respond click events, and we need to tell our application to know what you clicked notification. So for the bus we need to export only slot, so we can export only slot market as scriptable, and we creating a public slot market as scriptable. And adding signal. Let's rename it to on. Notification clicked. And our signal will be named as notification clicked. So when this slot will be executed, it will print some debug output to know it executed, and will emit notification clicked signal. Okay, now we have service, we have objects on this interface, and we have notification clicked signal and the notification clicked slot. Okay, I don't like this name too. Let's have it notification callback. And some parameter. And the parameter for a signal. Okay, now in notification helper we need to create some invocable for QML function to send a notification. Let it have two parameters, one for notification body and a second for notification main text. to include invite notification and include invite environment action, which will be used to set a remote action which will be executed, which will be called when a user click on a notification inside the events view. Okay, so notification function, inside this function we need to create a notification class object, and fill it with data. Remote action, and for this action, okay, remote action, la 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 la, okay, remote action, so this name is the bus name, path name, interface name, method name is notification callback, and arguments is a covariant list, and let's add additional property, okay, and set this section to notification action and publish notification. Show it to user and to notifications view. Okay, and now we need to register our classes, the QML. We need to include our classes. Now we can create these components on our page after adding input to these notifications. Creating the bus helper and on a clicked and we have parameter notification name, so it will be called to debug output, and the notification helper class notification helper. And we need more fields and a button. Next field. for body, one for summary. One for name and the button. Clicked. Notification helper. Send notification. It's body summary name. So body field. Text, summary field text, and name field text. Okay, send notification, should publish show notification. The boss should receive a notification callback. And the notification callback should emit notification clicked signal, and we will receive this signal here. Okay, we can test it now. If it's working or not working, we will see. Identification body, identification summary, and notification one. Okay, publish notification summary, notification body. You see, and if we click, finger is notification. We have finger clicking it, it disappearing, and okay, something went wrong, and we not receiving callback on our notification. Let's check what wrong. Test the bus. Using introspection, I see no method registered for our path. Export no script was closed. Slots I have mistyped here, so changed it to export scriptable slots, as our notification callback is scriptable, and notification helper. Okay, this way it should work. It started, and now it should work. Okay, I'm writing here motif one, pressing publish and clicking here, and we see user clicked motif one notification. Okay, let's use some name notification 2. Give a name motif 2, publish it, and then send our notification 3 with a name motif 3, publish it too. Okay. Okay, publish it, and go to events view. We see to notification, notification to notification free, and if we click on notification two, we will receive a callback telling us notification number, not number, notification with internal name notif two execute, and if we click on notification three, we will see notification with name notif three is executed. So this example is working.